Hello and good morning to ladies and gentlemen. I, Gayatri Kulkarni from Department of Information Technology of State LUJ and Sir MV College of Arts, Science and Commerce would like to welcome you all to the Green Tech Intercollegiate PowerPoint Presentation Competition, and for which the topic is Green Technology Problems and Sustainable Solutions. I would like to take opportunity to welcome our Honorable Director Ma'am, Mrs. Jyoti Gayatonde. It's an honor and privilege to have you, ma'am, with us today. I would like to welcome our IKSA coordinator and HOD of Computer Science Department, Dr. Mahendra Kanojia, sir. I also welcome the dignitaries, judges, teaching and non-teaching staff, participants and everyone. As we celebrate Women's Day today, I would like to wish you all a happy Women's Day to all the incredible women. Shine on, not just today, but every day.
Hi, this is Aisha. So with the grace of Almighty, let us begin. College is a place where a student develops his or her personality and various skills. This helps in escalating students' maturity levels. The college environment then becomes a major factor behind shaping students' mindset and enhances his or her perspective towards the world. So let's have a look at the infrastructure and environment of our college and get to know more about the college. As you can see, this is the history of our college. Our college was established in 1963. It is affiliated college to the University of Mumbai. We are sad not to have our trustee, late Sri Hemant Visanji, here today with us. Our current chairperson of the trust is Mrs. Arati Visanji. Meet our honorable director, ma'am, Mrs. Jyoti Gayatonde. She is truly a living example of leadership. I would like to introduce the IQSE coordinator, Dr. Mahendra Kanojia, sir. I would now request our head of Department of Computer Science, Dr. Mahendra Kanojia, sir, to enlighten us with a few words.
Good morning to one and all. Thanks for your invitation. And I can see that many students from various colleges have over a year been selected. So first of all, congratulations to all these shortlisted students. So you have already made it through the numerous amount of PPTs which has been submitted in this domain. And the idea is really very unique because the problem is going to be huge, large, and it is going to explode in the future with respect to the green tech if that has not been taken care now. So the overall planning for the IT department, which has been taken up to go ahead with the topic of green tech, where while participating, you must have definitely come across the problem, and others, those who are listening to this webinar today, will also come to know what are the various issues which we need to take care. And I believe the green tech issues can only be taken care by your habitual change in daily life. So I would congratulate Sneha Madam and the team for coming up with such a nice competition, and very best of luck to all the competitors who's over here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. That was very inspirational. I would like to introduce our director, ma'am, again. I would now request our director, ma'am, to enlighten us with a few words.
Without wasting much of your time with Professor Mahendra giving a good introduction, I just wish all the competitors all the best. And I congratulate again our IT coordinator, Sneha Madam, for organizing this competition, and all the best to all of you. Thank you so much for joining this platform. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for supporting us. So back again, these are the four self-finance degree courses available in our college: BSc in Information Technology, BSc in Biotechnology, BSc in Computer Science, and BMM. That is Bachelor's in Mass Media. Our college has two air-conditioned auditoriums, one on the ground floor and another on the first floor. Many of our seminars, celebrations are held here, like Teachers' Day celebrations, convocation ceremonies, and much more. Our food hub, which has good ambience and good quality food at pocket-friendly price, special care is taken to make sure that this place is always sanitized and hygienic. Our college has a huge playground for sports lovers,
all our outdoor sports events like cricket, football, basketball, etc. And also our fests are conducted here. As you can see, there is also a tennis court provided by our college. We have gymkhana for girls and boys on our ground floor. All our indoor games are played here, like carrom, chess, and many board games are kept here for us. For book lovers, there is a huge library. Our vast library has a distinct section for IT-oriented books. Our IT labs are fully-fledged AC labs equipped with new high-end systems. We will be performing our practicals here. We are on the ground floor. This is the biotech lab situated at the second floor. This is the CS lab on the ground floor. This is our media lab situated on the first floor, integrated with high-tech computers with graphic cards and graphic processors. As you can see, these are spacious and well-maintained classrooms. So this year, after the pandemic, when everything went offline, our college took many efforts and organized the cultural events for the academic year 2021 and 2022. This is our first day, our traditional day. This was the second day, the retro day, or the rainbow day. Every year, our college makes sure to take us to some campaigns for industrial visits, like Pune, Karjat, Pawai, Kerala, and many more. These are some intra-sports events in our college, like cricket, football, boxing, etc. and etc. Our college has a certification center called MVCC. You can visit and explore more about it on its official website, www.mvcc.com. These are the spacious classrooms in MVCC Center. These are all the listed courses available in MVCC Center, like Java certification, website development, cloud computing, artificial intelligence, and also they provide internships and placements. There is also a Google certified course of digital marketing offered by our college. These are some workshops and webinars conducted by our various departments of our college depending upon their field of specialty. Thank you.
Hello, this is Asya Qureshi introducing our judges, Assistant Professor Sneha Gokarnkar, the head of the Department of Information Technology, Assistant Professor Rohini Jagdale, Assistant Professor Marina G. Vegas, Assistant Professor Sumit Tripathi. I would like to invite Sneha ma'am to enlighten us with a few words.
Good morning, everyone. My warm welcome to all of you, and happy Women's Day to girls and ladies present here. It's a great pleasure to organize this event. And the main motive behind is to spread awareness on green technology, okay, which is the main going to be the main concern, like e-waste, carbon emission and all, to contain that. So it is a initial step to from our students so that we can give awareness to the society. So actually, from the first round, we got a very good response. Around 50 PPTs we received, and out of that, 15 have been shortlisted. So best of luck for all the 15 students who have been shortlisted. I would also like to express my gratitude to our director, ma'am, Mrs. Jyoti Gaikunde, ma'am, and our IQSE coordinator, Dr. Mahendra, sir, for their extending support to organize this event. Now, without taking much time, then it is better to start. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. The participants must have read the instructions or rules already. Or if you haven't yet, here are the instructions. Participants must listen to this carefully. Participants must join with their valid ID proofs on this link. Each participant will get 10 minutes to present their PowerPoint presentation. One must present the same PPT which has already been submitted. Participants must not change the content or edit the PPT. If found doing the same, will be disqualified. Participants must share their screen while presenting. Camera must be kept on throughout the presentation. I request all the participants to stay till the end of the meet. The winners will be announced in the end by our esteemed judges. Final decision will be taken by the judges. Without any further delay, let us begin with the competition. Wishing you all the very best for this competition, hoping that the best among you all wins.
Hi, this is Manjula. So let us begin with our first participant, GT01. GT01, can we have your camera switched on? Screen shared. Best of luck.
So I am Momin Ammarah Shoaib from GM Momin Women's College, studying in FYBSCIT. So today I'll present my presentation on green technology problems and sustainable solutions. I am Momin Ammarah Shoaib of FYBSCIT from GM Momin Women's College. So before starting this topic, I'd like to say Happy Women's Day to everyone and all my lovely ladies around the world. So, what exactly is green technology? Green technology is an environmental friendly technology, and some of the most common example of this technology is solar panels and wind turbines. So, it refers to environmental friendly technology and involves the uses of technology in production process using sustainable forms of energy. So, it's actually a very advantageous. But as every coin has two sides, it also has a lot of disadvantages. So today we are going to get an overview on what are the disadvantages of green technology. So here is the first disadvantage of green technology. So it's actually it is having high implementing costs. So because as this green technology is very new to the market, and it's a technology that is still very new in this industry. So the implementation cost of it is very high because it is eco-friendly also. Since people are very new to this, they might not know what is it, and they might not want to invest in the high implementation cost. So how can we solve this problem? So of course there's a solution for it. So the solution is to get big investors like who are interested in environment friendly technologies and people who are interested in creating an industry which is very environment friendly and which can help get our earth become a safe place for everyone. So we can propose big investors to invest in a project and make agreements with them, and this can help with implementing this high cost technology. So the next problem we have is lack of awareness to the public. So this is a very new technology, as I said, so not a lot of people are aware of it. Green technology term is still very new to common people. So they lack awareness of it. So they might simply not understand what exactly is green technology. So they will not be willing to pay for buying the green technology products, or they might not know what are the advantages of it. So how can we solve this problem? So we all have our favorite celebrity, we all have a favorite social media personality. So we can, with the help of those people, we can ask them and explain them like these are the very much importance of green technology. So they will help us make influence on the people which from their platform, and from that we can also have a very big impact on the common people because they are very influenced by celebrities and social media. So with the help of that, we can create awareness to people who are not aware of it. And by this, we can solve this problem. And the next we have is high product cost. Because it's very new and all technologies that are new are very expensive, is the same thing with high green technology. Though the product cost of green technology might shock the consumers, and consumers have to pay more until the green technology becomes more mature. So how can we solve this problem? So if a lot of people buy these technologies together and contribute to its cost, so the the total amount of payment will be comparatively less, and this can help reduce the amount of green technology and its individuality. And we can also buy green technology products to help our environment become more eco-friendly, and we can buy them during festival seasons or when there are many offers going on, and from this way we can help reduce the cost of it and make it more affordable. And next we have is misuse of green. As you know, advertisement is very important in today's life, so brands might use green technology to attract consumers and say that our technology is very eco-friendly, our brand is very eco-friendly, but they are actually not, because they are doing it in order to impress the consumers. And many companies advertise the brand to be eco-friendly, but they are not. So this word green is very misused by many companies to scam other people and for their own advantage. So how can we solve this problem? Legal actions are of course possible for such behavior, because they are scamming people, and we can educate people, common people, about this, that these are not actually the truth. So this might help in solving this problem. So we should all be very aware, and we all should take precaution against this. So next we have technical issues. Since the field of green technology is rather new, there might also be several technical issues related to it. So it may take time to optimize the process around green technology, and many companies might not want to invest in this for benefit that might wait for in the future. So these technological issues are very common. So how can we solve this? So we can introduce online courses related to green technology. And just like this seminar, we can also conduct seminars related to green technology to spread information about it, and it would attract more attention towards this topic. So from this, we can help create more awareness, and so that more people will be interested in green technology and more people will learn about it, and though technical issues will be solved. And the next we have is job loss. So of course, green technical implement and maintaining cost a lot of money. The possibility of companies going out of business is very high. So if companies in green technology industry go out of business, so of course a lot of people who work in there will lose their job. So in this hard time of pandemic, it's also very difficult for people to get jobs. So job losing is like one of the biggest problem of green technology. So how can we solve it? If a person works in green technology industry, it's always better to create an option B. So if that the company might run out of business, you can also go to another jobs. And it's important to work in company which have big investors, so that if even if the company runs out of business, there might be a better plan. So the conclusion is, of course, green technology is very important for our environment and advantages, but there are also some problems related to environment and technology that have to be addressed regulators in order to assure a framework where we as humanity can use green technology as efficiently as possible to improve our ecological footprint on a global scale. And of course, it's good to be habitual about it. We should implement in our daily life so that these problems can be solved. At last, thank you everyone for giving me this opportunity on giving such an important presentation on this topic. And this was me, Ammarah Momin of FYBSCIT from GM Momin Women's College. Thank you.
Yeah. Hello. Yeah. Mr. This is the question for GT01.
Yes.
You had put one slide that great personalities, if they are involved in this, they can advertise and all. So do you know any other personality, any personality who is advertising the green technology in this line?
There are many skincare brands or many makeup brands which are showing that they are using only green technology. They are not harming any environment, and they are not having like any
ingredient in the product that might harm the environment. So, for example, Mama Earth, this beauty brand, is also advertising their products as an eco-friendly product.
Okay, and you had put one slide that the due to green technology, okay, the many people chances of losing the job. So, how did you come to this judgment?
Because it's very new, and because we were living this past year in the global pandemic, so though all these plants, green technology plants, are mostly in outside, so we were all in lockdown and we were not allowed to go anywhere outside. And green technology is a technology that cannot be easily done through work from home, so it's very difficult for to keep and steadiest job in this department, in this industry. So that's why I said.
Okay, thank you. We can start the next one.
Thank you. That was good. So here we have our next participant, DD07. Can we have your camera switched on and screen shared? Best of luck.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning to judges, teachers, and one and all present here. I am Keshav Mishra from SY Department of Computer Science, from SET LUJ and Sir MV College. I am here because I have founded the green computing problem and I have the sustainable solution for this problem. Green tech, in our mind, for green tech, it generally means finding the solution of a problem that is affecting our environment, or it aims to protecting the environment and conservation of natural resources. So the green tech problem which I am addressing today is the email system. You might be wondering how email is connected to a green tech problem. Now I urge you to pull your attention toward the further discussion. How billions of email, including spam and unwanted email, impact the environment? This all questions we are coming in mind, but we don't think about it. Email, like how email is considering like in causing environment in environment impact, but it leaves carbon footprint in a huge amount. Do emails leave a carbon footprint? This is a question mark. It leaves a carbon footprint? Yeah, it really leaves a huge amount of carbon footprint. Like from how, like spam emails, which we got in daily, on a daily basis from where we have subscribed in website on other app, which we have subscribed, we got notification on a daily basis. And some emails which we don't want it. They generally stored on cloud or in a data server. Data center usually consume 1-2% of global electricity demand. This is a very big impacts of email. Like in a data center, we require a lot of electricity to generate them, and most of the country where the electricity is still produced from fossil fuel. This means prior emails were contributing to paper pollution, but now emails are not contributing to paper pollution at all, but they still contribute to carbon emission, which affects our environment. Like, you will be surprised to know that 306 billion of emails sent daily across a globe, and a standard email with no attachment produces maximum up to 4 grams of carbon dioxide, which we can calculate it would be 306 billion into 4 grams of carbon dioxide. So it would be 1.2 trillion grams of carbon dioxide. So it means on a daily basis, not a vehicle also producing so much carbon dioxide. And in emails which have attachments such as PDF links and all, then can produce up to 50 grams of carbon dioxide, which we can, if we calculate, it will really up to 15.5 trillion grams of carbon dioxide, which means it is most of the not a AC, not a vehicles. It is almost, we does not conclude email, because we think the smoke is not coming out of computer, so it means it is friendly, but it is having most impact in our world. On spam email, we generally got from from anywhere, like from in emails, like most of that, like thousands of emails daily we in our device daily comes. This is a MCFA study where 62 trillion spam emails were sent in 2008, which if we calculate that emission 0.3 grams of carbon dioxide equal to one message, so it would be similar to 32 billion kilowatt per hour. Means that would be if email could not spam emails would not be sent, then we can save up to 2.4 million homes electricity, like we, the 2.4 million homes can use this electricity. And this is the invert pyramid, how rapidly carbon emission increases in India from 1996 to 2021. The pie chart shows the growth rate of carbon emission in India. This is a country-wise bar graph. We are still at the seventh position, but with the competition of Green Tech event, which is organized today, we can spread awareness to all and we can march toward minimum country emission in Green Tech. We have discussed how adverse the is their problem. Is there any solution to this? Fortunately, yes. The huge problem has a simple solution related to our email habits. We have to make our email spam zero. But if I have thousands of spams pending in my mailbox, we feel or you feel lazy to delete those emails. But the approach is very simple. We can delete emails per day, like a habit one, like a habitual, like emails we don't need, we can delete them. But the approach, we can eventually will clean spam and unread email. This will decrease the carbon emission on a daily basis. Spam filtering saves up to 135 terabytes of electricity per year. If we calculate, there are 2.3 billion email users. If we calculate one email is equal to average one email is equal to 75 KB. So if everyone deletes 10 unwanted spam or unwanted daily emails, so we can save up to 17,25,000 GB of data from storing in the database, which is equal to like 1 GB of data takes up to 32 kilowatt electricity to use. So we can save up to 55.2 billion kilowatt electricity to prevent those server and storing data from this server. And that's cutting amount 39,035 metric tons of carbon dioxide, which is equivalent to 19,356 tons of coal burned every day to generate the amount of electricity. Like we have given the example of home, like if we delete this email, we can save up to 55 millions of homes, 55 million homes to get the electricity. That's a crazy amount of CO2 release in the atmosphere that would be saved, and our environment would be saved. Thank you.
Yes, the question goes to you, GT07.
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you for your question.
Yeah, like what made you to select the particular topic?
I have selected the email system, like how emails are impacting our environment on a daily basis.
Yeah, like why did you select the particular topic? This is something unique.
Yeah, I have such suggestion. Like we does not think we. When we think of like green tech, we only think of cars, industries, and other and all. We don't think of emails, which all uses in phone, laptop, or desktop. In any particular, we use emails like we are sending, but we did not aware of emails that emails is causing affecting our environment.
So, like, are there any other? Awareness of this, that email carbon emission,
yeah,
due to email.
Yeah, ma'am.
Anywhere else you have read or anywhere?
Yeah, ma'am. I have read in taken data from worldbank.org website, and I have taken one website reference. I did not know the name, but I will store finding to you. And I have taken this topic because I thought that no one aware of this such a particular topic, so I have taken.
Okay. Yes, Keshav.
Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Keshav, is there any application available in the market?
Yeah.
To filter out my spam email and normal emails.
Yeah, is yeah, sir. It is present, or we can make also like a spam, like we would generally send emails like thank you for only for responding, like thank you emails we send to all, like any spam emails. There is two three application also for that.
Okay, Keshav.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. GT07, this question is for you.
Yes, yes. Yes, ma'am.
What are the measures that you are using? Like, when did you come across this topic? As soon as you know, you came across this topic of spam mails and
things.
What are the measures that you are taking? Make the emails.
Yeah, ma'am. I have taken this topic because my I was pretty logging in emails. So that is number of email I got it like 1,200. So from that, the storage of my G drive, like, is it taking like 60 or 20% capacity of my drive? So I would not able to store any other PDFs on links. So I have taken this topic, like if we delete spam emails, so we can save our storage also, and to environment also we can save.
Yeah, so that's what I asked you. After you have come across this topic, what are the measures that you are taking to avoid spam mails?
So spam mails, ma'am, if spam mail comes, then I only delete those emails, like on a, I have said in my...
But like you told in your slides, spam mails are leaving carbon footprint.
Yes.
So how are we supposed to avoid them?
So spam emails to avoid them, no, ma'am?
Yeah, how do we avoid them? How do we avoid spam emails?
Ma'am, we cannot avoid them, but we spread awareness. Okay. Like, we can't say to any industry like they are sending those email which have subscribed. We are not say to that, but we spread awareness so that this awareness can go to that particular person and they can stop like spamming this email.
So there is no solution to stopping carbon footprints. You will have to just spread awareness. That's what you say.
Yeah, spread awareness and mostly like say. Like where we does not include emails, like when we does not include email, we can directly contact to other person. That is better than sending email.
Okay, fine.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. That was too good. So here we have our next participant, GT12. Can we have your camera switched on and screen shared? Best of luck.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sheetal Chauhan from FIBC IT, and I'm from Shankar Narayan College, and my topic is cooling. So why cooling is important in data centers? As shown here, to maintain environmental conditions suitable for the information technology equipment operations and to increase work efficiency. It means if we are not using cooling in data centers, it will directly harm to the our electronic equipment by overheating. So we must have to cool our electronic equipment. When they are cool, it will increase the work efficiency as well. Next slide is cooling cost. By study, it is proven that the majority of cost is containing cooling only rather than the IT industries. If we want to reduce our cooling cost, we must have to cover our windows and we must have to service our air conditions. Also, we have to avoid while we are cooling, we must have to avoid the stovens and the ovens as well. Next is cooling, how we calculate our cooling needs. So first we must have to know what is BTU. So BTU is the British thermal unit. So for we have to calculate our cooling needs. For that we requires our room area BTU, and we require window BTU. We require total occupant BTU, means in a room how many people are there. So we require that BTU. We require equipment BTU as well as light BTU. We are adding this all BTU, so we'll get the total cooling requirement. So this is the formula for calculating our cooling needs. Moving to the next, reducing cooling cost. How we reduce our cooling cost? So first is economizers. Economizers in simple means we are using natural resources for cooling our data centers. Like we are using air and water. So there are two types of economizers. First is air side economizers and second is water side economizers. So air side economizers, it means we are using the natural air from the window for cooling our data centers. For cooling our data centers by air, we require the three equipments, that is sensors, second is pipes, and third is absorbers. We require sensors for measuring the temperature. We require pipes for ventilation of air. We require absorbers for the pressure. For these, we are cooling our data centers. And next is water side economizers. In that, we are using chilled water to compressed air. From that, we are cool our data centers easily. In water side economizers, the benefits is in the room humidity will decrease, so our electronic equipment will be more efficient. Moving to the next, optimizing airflow, it means we must have to optimize our airflow in the data centers by a particular hour. There should be the fresh air circulated in every hours. In normal office and small offices, we must have to circulate our air in twice an hour. And in high density office and companies, we have to circulate our air in 50 times an hour. Moving to the next, raised floor. Raised floor is the data center's constructed model. Means we have to make the data center slightly higher than the normal floors, and the range is the 18 to 236 inches. So our from the raised floors, the cooling is going very easily. So to keep servers cool and prevent the problems that comes with overheating. So from raised floors, the overheating problem will decrease, and electronic equipments work properly. Moving to the next, cable management. So cable management are two types. One is organized and second is unorganized. So organized cable management, we have to organize our cable properly in every data centers, so the data will go easily. And unorganized data management and cable will decrease the work efficiency. Like if we are unorganized cable management, so the data and cooling will trap in middle, so the work efficiency will low. If we are cable managing properly, it will more energy efficiency. Moving to the next, data centers design. Whenever we are design our data centers, we must have to think first cooling. We must have to keep cooling in our mind whenever we are constructing data centers. We must have to construct data centers as per our need. So that is reduce the amount of cooling. So it will make the cooling properly. This is the figure of data centers cooling. As is shown in the figure, blue lines, it will shows the cooling, and the red arrow shows the hot air that is go outside the data centers. Thank you.
Yes, the question goes to you, like what level this impact is, that raised floors, what you said, in data centers, what level it is impacting in saving energy and cooling, how it is impacting cooling? Can you explain elaborately?
Raised floors means by raising floors, the cooling air will go inside the raised floors and it will go properly to every racks of the data centers.
Okay. What made you to select this topic?
Sorry, ma'am.
Why did you select this particular topic, data center cooling?
Because nowadays we are seeing that the more IT industries is developing day by day. So if we are not cooling our data center, our products is damaged and that is converted to waste. So from that is e-waste is generating. So we must have to cool our data centers from that our equipment is working properly. So waste is reduced from that purpose.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. That was too good. Thank you, everyone, for such an amazing and interesting presentation. Our judges will be giving their decision soon, so kindly wait in the meeting for a while.
Hi, this is Tanashree. Here we are for the most awaited moment. Firstly, I would like to thank all the participants for the efforts and active participation for this making event successful. I think everybody is pretty excited. Yes, so let us begin now. The winner for the Green Tech Intercollegiate PowerPoint presentation competition are first, I will be announcing the second runner-up. Our second runner-up. Our second runner-up goes to Keshav Mishra, GT07 from MVLU College. Congratulations. Our first runner-up goes to Sheetal Chauhan, GT12 from Shankar Narayan College of Arts and Commerce. Congratulations. Oh, our first winner is Ammarah Momin, GT01 from GM Momin Women's College. Congratulations. Congratulations to all the winners. Keep going and growing. Thank you.
Hello and good afternoon. This is Parth Panchal. I am here for expressing a vote of thanks. At the outset of heartfelt, thank you to all the judges indeed. It was very enriching and learning experience. We extend our sincere thanks and appreciation for your valuable time and insight. Also thanks to our director ma'am, Mrs. Jyoti Kaitonde and Dr. Mahindra Kanoja sir, who graced this occasion in spite of busy schedule. I would also like to thank all the judges and Green Tech Organization Committee who made this insightful competition possible. And lastly, all the students who have participated with full interest and made this competition a lively session. A huge thanks to all of you. It was a great pleasure and also a big congratulations to our winners. Keep going. Have a great day ahead.
Thank you.